You know why we're afraid? Because this dog is vicious and he is violent. And this girl is about 5 foot tall and about 90 pounds. And I'm pretty sure she's a crackhead. So, what does she do? She walks it out there and she locks it right there, chained to the fence. She yells at it, bad dog, shut up. No, you're not coming in, bad dog. As you can see, there is no access to water. It is very hot, over 100 degrees here in Florida. And she refuses to bring it in. Now, my problem is that this property right here, all this is my yard. This is all my yard. I have a tiny dog and I walk it every day in my yard. And every day I have issues because I cannot walk this dog. I cannot trust my children to walk my dog because if this dog turns around and attacks my children, they are going to have issues. If their dog turns around and attacks and eats my dog, they are going to have serious issues. Now, one day she turns around and she locks the dog in that screen house. The dog sees me walking my dog and it attacks the screen, jumps at the door, wobbles the door. It could totally jump through the screen if it wanted to. What does she do? Nothing. She leaves it there. The dog knocks over her 2-year-old granddaughter, who she takes care of because her children are incapable of doing so. Then she yells at the dog for knocking over her dog, when in all reality, if she just took proper care of her animal and did the right thing, then maybe there would be no issues. So I am considering calling domestic animal services on her because she is a horrible dog owner. This dog right here, all it does is bark and bark and bark. It could be out there for hours upon hours upon hours of time. It wakes us up on weekends. It wakes us up on weekdays. It is out there all day long. Do you hear it barking? It's been barking this entire time. It's 2 minutes. 2 minutes and 2 seconds right now. It's all it's doing is barking. But what you don't know is this dog has been outside for over a half hour before I decided to come outside and record it for my YouTube. Now, I am an animal activist. I am an animal rescue. And I am fully 100% against animal abuse. A dark dog, a black dog of this size, should have proper shade, should have proper drinking water, should have proper care. But because they refuse to do what they need to do to take care of this dog, they cause my family issues. I can no longer walk my dog in the backyard because that dog chases us and attacks us. When he attacked me, going after my dog, and I lifted him up over my head as far as my arms could possibly reach, she could not take care of the dog. She could not withstand the strength of the dog. It drug her. She dropped the leash. It attacked me. So what do? They chain it right there to that tree, and they leave it there all day. Sometimes they'll go to work. It'll be outside all day long. So all I'm saying is, if you are going to have an animal, take proper care of it. If you are going to have an animal, walk it. If you are going to have an animal, make sure it has proper water and food source. It is not healthy for that dog. Do you have any idea at all how many animals turn around and have heat stroke and die because they are left outside, unaccompanied, no attention? No one's paying attention to it. There's no water, no shade, no shelter for this animal whatsoever. Put it in that screenhouse. Great, fine, dandy. It's still hot as anything in there. Plus, let's not forget, that dog is strong enough to bust through that screen. It is strong enough to break through that door. I am not trying to get attacked by this lady's dog, and she is not trying to be a responsible pet owner. So all I'm saying is, if you are going to have a dog or an animal, take proper care of it or don't have it at all. Maybe at 90 pounds, she should have got a chihuahua. Then she could have walked it and taken proper care of it. Or maybe she should have her lazy son walk the dog because he is twice her size and he is fully capable of walking this dog and taking care of it. But here we go, barking 4 minutes and 26 seconds into this video. And guess what? He's been out here for, like I said, over a half hour. Bark, 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 barking. And you know what? He's not even a nice dog. He's a dangerous dog. Should he break off of that leash? He will come after me. He will come after my animals. He will come after my children. And you know what they think? Oh, it's all fun and games. I'm so sorry. Please don't even be upset, because you know what? At the end of the day, the dog is just trying to be a dog. No, I'm sorry, the dog is not trying to be a dog. And you can't even see. I can see her walking around past her sliding glass door, back and forth, looking at her dog. I'm just waiting for her to come outside and yell at the dog, saying, no, you cannot come in, or no, you're being a bad dog, or no, shut up. How long do you think that dog really is going to take to go to the bathroom? How long does it take? 10 minutes maybe, at that? If that, yeah, no. It's out there for hours and hours and hours and hours. They go to work, they leave it. They do housework, they leave it. They want nothing to do with it. Why? Because he's a hassle and they don't like it. They do not want it in the house. They do not want it around the grandchild because it is dangerous towards the grandchild. So if it's dangerous towards your grandchild and your family, you really think that it's proper to have this dog who now is in my yard, across the property line, in my yard, you think it's safe to have him right next door to your brand new neighbors who, oh, wait, I know I admitted it once, but he attacked me. So do you really think that's safe? Because I don't think it's safe. If you're going to have a dog, do the right thing, or people like me will report you. Bottom line, take care of your animals, do the right thing, come out of your damn house, walk your dog, put him away, take care of him, maybe give him water, or don't have an animal. This is Critter Corner. Please, if you have not already liked and subscribed, do. If you feel like it, please, by all means, leave a comment. Thank you. Oh, just in case we forgot, there he is, still outside. And you know what? It's over 100 degrees out right now. Just saying, over 100 degrees, and that dog has zero reason to be outside right now. I wish that lady would come outside right now and ask me what I'm doing so I could tell her what I was doing. But she won't. You know why she won't? Because she knows that there will be an issue. So, this may be the first of many videos of this dog outside. Because when I'm inside my house, all I do is hear it bark, 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 barking. When my kids walk the dog, they run away scared. When I walk the dog, I carry a knife. Because if it breaks off and it comes after me and my dog, I promise you one thing, it ain't gonna be me or my dog getting killed, attacked, or mauled. It will be her dog. Maybe she'll learn her lesson then. Because you know what? People like that do not deserve to own an animal. Everybody, like, subscribe, share, follow me on Critter Corner 1 at Instagram. Thank y'all. Have a great night.